On this channel, and indeed soon on my new channel, Event Horizon, link below, I often discuss the possibilities regarding microbial life in the universe, and, of course, if that life might evolve to be more, even spawning potential civilizations. But there's one other possibility that I haven't yet discussed. Call it more an indicator of life than actual life itself. It's the potential that our first detection of evidence of alien life may not be alive at all. Instead, it may be a virus. Viruses tend to be very tiny, far smaller than bacteria, and generally are not considered by scientists to be alive, but are certainly related to life, as you see when you catch a cold. While viruses are dependent on living cells to reproduce, they also absolutely dominate this planet in numbers. Viruses are everywhere you find life, and like life, could be transferred to other worlds by panspermia just as easily as microbial life might. It may be the case that viruses co-develop with life commonly, in which case, many of the habitable planets in the universe may also be similarly dominated by viruses. The idea that this is a universe teeming also with viruses is disconcerting. Within sci-fi, of course, there is the trope of alien viruses infecting humans, but that would be extremely difficult for such viruses to do. They simply wouldn't be designed to do it. Unfortunately, that also makes viruses in general difficult to study because they tend to be very specialized, having evolved alongside their hosts. Viruses tend to specialize in what they evolved to infect. This is why your pet goldfish doesn't catch a cold when you have one, though of course crosses such as bird and swine flu do occur. But we know little about most viruses infecting cells on this planet, other than the handful that affect us. In fact, scientists running across viruses often aren't even sure what their host actually is, and therefore they are difficult to culture and study. Evidence of an alien virus would be far more difficult to interpret, if you could even find it at all. This is beginning to change, however, as techniques and technology improves, opening the possibility of at least looking for alien viruses in odd meteorites or at places such as Europa. But this brings up a question. What happens if we find life somewhere else in the solar system, but it has no viruses? Whether viruses are a natural companion to cellular life is unknown. But there is some thinking that viruses appeared on Earth very early and might have helped drive the evolution of life itself. Viruses aren't always a bad thing. In fact, they are actively being used to develop drugs to treat diseases like cancer because of their direct access to cells. But in nature, they can pass genes from cell to cell, and sometimes those genes can actually be beneficial to an organism. But another aspect of viruses is that since they are not the same thing as life, generally they are simpler. So when they are dormant, they can last a long time. With no host inside a meteorite, they might basically just sit there for a long period of time if they don't get damaged by radiation. So now we have the opposite scenario. Say we found evidence of an alien virus, say in an ice shell moon like Europa, but not life itself. That would strongly indicate that it co-evolved with life, but it would tell us little about that life, only that something exists or existed somewhere in Europa's ocean that co-evolved with a virus. Past that, we wouldn't be able to culture that virus or easily learn much more. In other words, it's possible that a world that may once have had life but no longer does may still have viruses. Viruses on Earth are host-specific, mainly because there are so many options for hosts here. But on a planet like Mars that once had the conditions for life, virus evolution may have gone in a very different direction. It may be possible that viruses could be forced to generalize on an otherwise dying world. As the hypothetical microbial Martian life died off as the planet became inhospitable for it, the viruses may have evolved to attack any cell they could in order to reproduce. Given enough generalization, that could hypothetically even mean us. More, our own viruses may actually outlive life on Earth. The sun's luminosity is increasing, and in the future this world will become increasingly uninhabitable. With less and less hosts available, the viruses may evolve the ability to directly share genetic information between themselves in the absence of hosts. Given that Earth viruses are pretty resilient, they've been found in extreme environments on this planet, they may outlast life on this world entirely, or may have done so on Mars, possibly leaving them as the last holdout of some kind of life-related organics in this star system. Thanks for listening. I am futurist and science fiction author John Michael Godier, currently thanking all of you that have subscribed to the new channel, Event Horizon, link below. It's gone well, and a second preview comes out this week. But my computers are acting just weird. They keep turning on at all hours of the night and telling me things like I need more fiber in my diet and asking why I speak English so strangely. And be sure to check out my books at your favorite online book retailer and subscribe to my channel for regular in-depth explorations into the interesting, weird, and unknown aspects of this amazing universe in which we live.